Helen here, Helen Plath from Nurture Mamas. I hope you're doing really well. So today I'm going to do a short sequence which will prepare you for sleep. So I know, particularly being pregnant, sometimes the mind is racing or the body feels a bit uncomfortable and it's quite hard to get to sleep. Or you might wake up during the night and you can't go back to sleep. So today I'm just going to do a short sequence you can do before you get into bed to really try and relax all the muscles and the mind, and it's a nice one to just zone out a little bit and get the body ready for sleep. So I'm 19 weeks pregnant at the moment. It's suitable, this one, for any stage of pregnancy. So we're going to start off in a child's pose. So just popping the legs to one side. I'm going to have today lots of cushions. So you can have rolled up blankets, pillows, yoga blocks, or anything at all that is comfortable for you. So today is all about comfort. Okay, so I'm going to come onto the hands and the knees again. If you're on quite a hard surface, you can make a fold in your mat or put pillows or cushions under your knee and to pop the knees on so they're nice and comfortable. So I'm going to come onto my knees and just go a little bit wider, bring the toes together and sit the bum down to the heels. And then come down into a child's pose. So any version that's comfortable for you. You can have a cushion if you want to. You can have your arms straight out in child's pose or just cross them over or rest the head down. Really whatever is comfortable for you. And while we're in this position, we're just going to take a couple of big deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. So with every exhale, you want to try and release and really let go of any tension through the shoulders, through the forehead. Really full deep breaths here. And just giving yourself permission to enjoy this time just for you at the end of the day. So a couple of more big deep breaths here. And then you can stay down in child's pose really for as long as you like. But I'm going to come up now. So I'm going to come into just a really comfortable seated position. So I'm going to sit on the edge of my cushion here. And then I'm also just going to spoil myself a little bit and pop a cushion down in front of me and come into just like an easy cross-legged position. So you don't have to, particularly if you have any sort of SPD, pelvic pain or anything, you want to keep your legs straight out in front of you or sitting on your knees. So you don't want to be opening into the hips at all if you have any pelvic pain. So here I'm just super comfortable. Excuse me, nice, and my knees are very high off the floor, but it's comfortable for me. And you might want to have yoga blocks or pillows to support your knees. So now we're just going to close the eyes if you want to and release the head and the neck. So we'll pop the chin down to the chest and then come back up, and without moving the shoulders, drop the right ear to the right shoulder and then look over that shoulder back to the center. Left ear to the left shoulder, look over the shoulder, center, head all the way back, and back to the center. So we'll do that again, chin to the chest, head back, right ear to the right shoulder, looking over the shoulder, center, left ear to the left shoulder, looking over the shoulder, back to the center, and head back. And then we'll come back and we're going to take the hands behind us now onto our fingertips and really get your back nice and straight here and press the chest forward. So you're pressing the chest forward, bring the shoulder blades together. You can just look straight ahead or drop the head all the way back. I don't really find that comfortable, so I'm just going to stay here looking forward. Again, big deep breaths here in through the nose, out through the mouth or the nose, whatever's comfortable for you. Just opening into the chest. And then nice and slowly, we're going to take the hands forward and we're going to crawl forward. So you want to keep the back fairly straight here. So you mightn't get very far, that's fine. Or you might have quite a big bump at this stage. So just due to your point of comfort. You might feel it if you're sitting in this kind of a position a little bit in releasing into the outside of the hips. So we're coming forward. And then if your legs are quite low to the ground, you don't have a cushion, you can pop your head either on a couple of blankets or pillows rolled up. So we're just going to stay here for a couple of moments. Hinging forward all the time, a little bit more, but you're hinging from the hips here. And then coming back up. And then we're going to start to release the shoulders. So take the arms out in front of you and bend the elbows. We'll take the left hand underneath the right elbow and see if you can bind the hands together. If you can't, don't worry. Just drop the hand and draw the right shoulder across the body towards you. Otherwise, we're going to lift the elbows up and the hands come away from the face. So your eagle arms here. So we're going to hold it here. Try and keep the elbows lifted. A few nice big deep breaths. So you don't want to have your ears all kind of your shoulders squashed up to your ears. So relax your shoulders down, but don't let the elbows drop. So it's quite a good strong stretch into the shoulders, releasing them at the end of the day. And then nice and slowly lower down the elbows, unbind, and just do a few nice shoulder rolls here. And then we'll go to the other side. So bring the arms out again, bend the elbows. This time your right arm goes under your left elbow. And then again, see if you can make the bind. If not, just drop and draw that left shoulder towards you. So lifting up, relax those shoulders, keep the chest and the elbows off each other. So lift those elbows up, hands away from the face. You can close the eyes or just gaze at the forearms. A couple of nice big deep breaths. And then nice and slowly, lower down. Just unravel, relax the shoulders, and then we'll do a real gentle twist. So I'm going to take my left hand behind me into the center of my back and my right hand where it falls on my knee. So you want to keep your hips forward here. So big deep breath in, sit up super tall, and then exhale and twist. So relax the shoulders as you're looking over the left shoulder. You don't want to feel a pulling sensation though on the belly. So just relax into it, take a few breaths in. Every inhale, lift a little taller. Every exhale, turn a little more. And then come back to the center and we're just gonna swap the sides. So big deep breath in, sit up tall. Exhale, turn. We're just staying here, relaxing through the shoulders. And then coming back up. So I'm going to get back onto the hands and the knees now. So do this at whatever pace you want to. So you're going to remove anything that was on your mat and we'll come back to the hands and the knees. Okay, so nice and slowly bring the legs to one side, hands down and pop yourself up. Again, you might want to pop yourself back onto the pillow, shoulders on top of the wrist, knees can be however width apart, whatever's comfortable. I'm just going to do a little hip circle here in both directions, just releasing into the lower back a bit, just rolling through the pelvis. And then from here, we'll go into a couple of cat-cows. So nice breath in through the nose. Exhale, you're going to draw baby in towards you, lift up the pelvic floor, round the back, chin to the chest. Dip the belly down, the bum up, shoulders back, big breath in. Exhale, hug baby, lift up the pelvic floor around the back. Inhaling again. Exhale. So again, you can close the eyes here. Do as many of these as you want to. I'm just going to do one more. And then we'll come back to just a flat back. And I'm going to go into a sort of a child's pose, except this one you want, it's quite nice to get a bit more of a stretch in through the upper back, the shoulders and across the chest. So I'm going to take my hands out further in front of me, so in front of my shoulders, and it's extremely attractive. I'm going to keep my bum sticking up in the air and I'm going to be pressing my chest towards the floor. So again, you can rest your head down or to one side or do whatever is comfortable for you, but you're really lengthening through that upper body in through the back and just allow yourself to release the upper back and the shoulders here for a few breaths. And then nice and slowly bring yourself back up and we're going to come into a downward facing dog. So you can take anything that was on the mat away and press the hands down into your mat, curl the toes under, pop the bum up in the air, and then push away from your hands. So you might want to bend your knees, you might want to pedal the legs one at a time. But for down dog, if you feel a little bit heady or you've high blood pressure, I wouldn't be doing this one. So you're pushing your hips up high into the air and then coming down for a nice child's pose or supported child's pose. Just make sure your head is rested. And if it doesn't feel good to be down this low, of course, come up onto your bum and just take a few breaths here. So I'm going to do that one more time. If you don't like the feeling of being up and down dog, just do a child's pose, okay? So hands down into your mat, curl the toes, pop the bum up in the air, and then lengthening through the back of the legs and through the whole way up the back. You can bend the knees or remembering what I said, this is all about comfort here. So relax the shoulders, strong legs, hips up into the air. And then coming back down for just one more child's pose, resting the head down, letting the body settle. Remembering this is a sequence for just before bed, so you want to make sure you're nice and gentle to yourself. Okay, so the next one I'm going to go through is pigeon pose. A little bit tricky to get into, so just follow my lead. You might want to watch this first and then go into it. So pigeon pose is amazing to release all around the glutes, so the bum, the hips, the lower back, and it can also be really good if you have some sciatic pain coming down one leg. So I'm going to start on my nice tight side, which is my right side. I have kind of a tighter hip on my right side. And I'm going to start from the hands and the knees, and then I'm going to be bringing my right knee to the outside of my right wrist. So big stretch up. My left knee goes back a little bit, straight though, so it's not coming out to the side. And then this right foot might move a little bit, or maybe completely parallel, depending on how your body is, a little bit up to where that left hand once was. So I kind of have to manhandle my foot a little bit. And then you want to push both hips straight down into the floor. Okay, so we're going to stay up here, so you'll feel a strong stretch in the outside of the right hip and buttock. So you can stay up nice and high here. Really depends how low you go in terms of how low and how big your bump is to the ground. So you can stay up here, and really in this pose, I try and stay in for a few minutes aside if you can. So you can start to slowly work your way down towards the floor, maybe even grab a cushion, and eventually coming to rest the head down. So remember, the two hips are pushing down into your mat, and really just tell the muscles to release. They're really big, you know, tough muscles. They've a lot of work to do during the day, and for most people they're very, very tight. So make sure that you're not falling back to the right-hand side, you're falling to the hip and the bum. You need to be pressing that left hip down into the mat as well. So relax the shoulders, relax the forehead. So if I was doing this myself, I would probably stay in this pose for a lot longer, if I was practicing just before bed. So, but now I'm just going to show you how to come out of it. So bring your hands back up, and then you're going to scoot, curl the toes under that left foot, and just scoot the left knee forward a bit, and then slide the right leg back. Okay, so we're going to do that on the other side. So this time I'm taking my left hip to the left knee to the outside of that left wrist, and then scooting the right hip back, taking that left foot up towards, you're trying to get the shin bone pretty much parallel to the front of your mat, but that might take years, or you might never get there. So the right leg, you want it straight out behind you, and the same thing. You'll feel one all around here. You'll feel one side probably much tighter than the other. So we'll just stay here for a few moments, pushing both hips down into the mat. And then we're going to start to fall forward a little. And you might stay up quite high. It's quite nice to let your head rest onto something so you can make little fists of your hands. And really just release into that left side of the hip. it. So you can stay again for as long as you want to. It's quite a good owie, as I like to call it. So when you want to come out of it, you're going to bring your hands back up, curl the right toes under, bring the right knee forward a little, slide that left leg back. And I'm just going to do one simple down dog again and come into child's pose after. So just nice bending through the knees. And then come back down for child's pose, just a final little rest. And then when you're ready, you can come back up to sit or hopefully roll into bed. So I hope you really enjoy that. Any questions at all, just let me know underneath the comments. If you've any suggestions of videos that you'd like me to do, please just let me know. And I'd really appreciate it if you liked the video and shared it with your friends. So thank you so much. I will see you next week. Please God, take care.